You're watching Mr. Prima Vision, and thank you for joining me, guys. Now, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, she's an athlete, a mother, a UNICEF ambassador, and children's book author, and so many other things, and also an inspiration to so many young Jamaican women and men. Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, like so many successful athletes, there's a parent, in this case, her mother, Maxine Simpson, who used to be a runner, but never got the opportunity to pursue track after her teenage years. Shelly-Ann says, "My mother is probably one of the biggest reasons why I'm running, because she used to run and she stopped because she got pregnant with my big brother, Omar." Shelly also has another brother called Andrew. Fraser-Pryce described her family as being close-knit, but they were far from wealthy and experienced extreme hardship during her early years. "My mother encouraged me a lot, and I really loved her because when nobody else was there, she always made sure to provide for us. I ran at primary champs barefooted, and I really put in a lot of hard work to get where I am now." So as a result of this, you see that Shelly has developed a passion for helping underprivileged kids, born from her own experience growing up in Waterhouse. She goes on to say, "When I started high school in 1999 at Ulmer's Girls, I was privileged and blessed at the same time to have met a woman by the name of Jean Cook of the Ulmer's Old Girls Association. She saw something in me that I didn't see at all and started to fund my education, my books, my uniform, my lunch, everything. Showed me compassion and love in so many ways, and that's where everything is fueled from. Now, Jamaica is able to enjoy the success of a Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce because of the hard work and determination of her mother, Maxine Simpson, and the compassion of her mentor, Jean Cook. And we want to commend these ladies for helping and seeing the potential in this young lady and helping to produce a sparkling example of what one can be when they put their mind to something and work hard for it.